They call these dying lands the Divide. A bitter waste born from a terrible disaster. Only scavenger tribes remain. All hopes rest with those who undertake a perilous journey. Guided by an arcane prophecy, they seek salvation among the ruins. None have succeeded. And yet, again, one of the tribe's youngest has volunteered for the voyage. Abby's canoe runs aground upon the deserted shore. She adjusts the dials on her crude comms unit.
I've reached the other side. It feels haunted.
You are entering the Divide, Abby. The tombland of a dead people. You'll find many echoes of their downfall. Be careful. There is danger in the ruins.
I'm ready for it, Amitai.
Others went before, believing the same. The Divide ticks, but only those humbled by their ordeals can broker peace with the gods.
The channel clicks off. Abby begins her march across the Divide's deadlands. The elders warned Abby about the vicious guardians. Despite her powers, it is not easy to control them. The clifftops ahead echo with more anguished shrieks. Thank you. Abby's comms unit emits a sharp crackle. For the first time in days, she hears her father's voice.
I can't push the fear from my mind, Abby.
Don't worry, Father. My powers are stronger now than when I left. I'll resist the God's toll.
I hope you're right. Those who went before couldn't do it. All that their minds held was taken from them in the Divide. The gods showed no mercy.
The strongest must attempt the crossing. There's no other way.
I always feared you would volunteer one day. After Isaac left, you became so focused on your training, your powers grew quickly.
My Isaac is not why I volunteered.
It was always hard for you to speak about him. The Divide has already taken so much from you.
I try not to think about it. I should keep moving.
Abby stifles a tear, breaking the otherwise hollow silence. She repacks her comms unit and resumes her progress.